We are beginning tonight with the aftermath of this weekend's storm and the damage left behind. The most evidence, the landslide on Highway 1, 25 miles south of Big Sur. This is near Limekiln Creek, right at the Monterey County line. Caltrans says the highway is now closed in both directions, and they don't know when they'll be able to reopen it. As for the rest of the cleanup, we've got live team coverage from Monterey County up to the Santa Cruz Mountains, and that's where we begin with Action News reporter Phil Gomez. Phil?
Well, Dan, lots of rainfall in the Santa Cruz Mountains, but not a lot of problems. The month of December was the second driest in the city's history, so there was little runoff to cause big flooding or mudslides, but there was cleanup today to prevent any future problems. Caltrans scooped up pine needles by the bucketful, debris that could clog storm drains and culverts along the three major roadways, Highway 9, 1, and 17.
We had these flash rains, and so we had a lot of pine needles coming down into our culverts. And as pine needles came down the culverts, they were plugging up our culverts pretty quick. So that's what I have the crews out right now, cleaning up the culverts and all the debris and limbs and from the wind.
Loch Lomond Reservoir, the Santa Cruz Water Department's reserve water supply, is 95% full, but the rainfall is far too short of what's needed to replenish the city's watershed. Runoff has filled the San Lorenzo River, which is the city's largest source of drinking water for its 90,000 customers, but it's far short of what's needed.
It's hard to compare because, you know, there's still a lot of the rain season to come, but if you just compare where we are to date with where we should be to date, we're 70% behind.
High surf washed two boats onto shore. This one at Seabright was beaten up pretty good. High surf also forced the closure of the Santa Cruz Harbor boat launch for the last 3 days.
We're trying to keep boaters out. We'll assess things tomorrow morning, Tuesday. We do expect some large surf to continue right through until Wednesday. So we're advising boaters, you know, to stay inside. We're advising people on land to, you know, stay back, view the surf from a safe distance.
Again, this past December was the second driest in the Water Department's recorded history. The only year drier was back in 1989, which was the second year of a five-year drought. Aaron, Dan.
All right,
Phil, thank you.
Phil, thank you. Now I want to get more of a look at storm damage around Monterey County. We continue our team coverage. I'm going to Action News reporter May Chow live in Salinas.
Dan, Aaron, plenty of rain and gusty wind along the peninsula, but not a lot of damage to report. Obviously, heavy surf along the coast, and here in Salinas, the biggest damage came from two uprooted trees. It was an unwelcome sight for anyone getting up to go to work in the morning. This was the scene early Monday on Oregon and Linden Streets in East Salinas. Overnight showers and strong winds caused this tree to topple over, crushing a truck. This was one of two trees which fell over in Salinas. The downpour also saturated the ground on Oak in California, causing this one to crash onto the pavement. Luckily, no injuries were reported, but still a big mess to clean up. But that was the extent of damage Salinas saw after the season's first storm.
We're fairly lucky. We didn't get hit very hard. There were a couple trees down. I think I don't want to minimize the damage that it's caused, but since one person got his truck hit by a falling tree, some power lines down.
There were a number of clogged storm drains caused by leaves, branches, and trash, but nothing that required the city to mobilize public work crews this weekend. Garbage cans were blown over, causing somewhat of a soggy mess for some homeowners.
We were very lucky that this year so far we've been unscathed, almost unscathed.
Around 500 PG&E customers on the peninsula did lose power sometime overnight early this morning, but PG&E spent the day restoring power as well as preparing for when the next system will move in. Aaron, Dan.
All right, May, thank you.